In this example, we're going to demonstrate signals, slots, and property bindings. Property bindings are a core feature of QML that let developers specify a relationship between object properties, so when one changes, the other one automatically changes as well. In this example, we're going to have a sender object emit a signal to a receiver object, and you'll see that update in real time, along with custom property bindings. First thing we need to do is let's create a background. In this background, we're going to add a rectangle. And let's set this to autofill the parent. And let's set the background color to a gradient. There we go. Super easy. Next, we're going to create our own custom component. Select a QQuick UI file. Let's call this circle. And we're going to set our initial width and height. Let's add a rectangle. And let's make sure that fills the parent and set the background color. Let's select that rectangle and let's call this button. And let's set the radius. Next, let's add a text field. This will give the user some feedback. Let's center it, and let's change some properties. Let's change the ID to display. And to truly make this reusable, let's export some properties. For example, we want to export the text. And we want to export this color. When we look at the text editor, we can see that we are exporting property aliases. Before we can begin emitting signals, we need a slot to receive them. So we create a new quick file. Let's call this receiver. And let's change this to circle, the component we just made. All right, let's give this an identifier. And the slot. In here, we want to update the display text. The display text is the value or the property that we exported earlier. Also, we want a sequential animation. And we want this on the button color. Button color is also the alias that we exported earlier. Give this an ID. And let's set this running to false. Because we don't want this running until we actually trigger it. Inside the sequential animation, let's make a color animation. We want to go from red to blue. And we want this to go 250 milliseconds. Then we want another color animation going from blue to red. Let's turn that animation on. Now, when we receive the signal, we'll update the display text and start an animation. Now let's create our sender. Let's create a QML file and call it sender. Change this from item to circle. Let's go ahead and fill this in. First thing we're going to do is make an ID. Then we're going to make some properties. First property is going to be an integer, and it's going to be a counter. Every time this component is clicked, we're going to increment a counter. Second property is going to be the receiver. And we're going to call this target. this is going to be the component that we're going to send the signal to. Its initial value is going to be null because we don't want to set that. Next, let's create our signal. We're going to send a string value. And when the target is changed, we want to actually bind this. So let's say send.connect target receive. Now let's make the sender clickable. We'll do this by adding a mouse area. We're going to fill the parent. And we want to be able to click this. So onClicked, we're going to add a bit of JavaScript here. We're going to say counter. We're going to increment that. And we're going to call the send function in the parent. We also want some visual feedback. So onPressed, we're going to set the color to, let's say, green. And on released, let's set the parent color back to blue. Let's tie all this together. Let's open up the main and let's open this in design mode. First thing we're going to do is switch this back to form editor and let's put the background on here. And we're going to add the sender and a receiver. We're going to anchor that, and let's set the margin to 50. Let's anchor this as well and set that to 50. Let's modify the properties of our components. And let's go ahead and set the target. That way, the signal knows where the slot is. Let's go ahead and run this, and let's see what it looks like. Now, when we click the sender, you can see we get visual feedback and the counter is incremented. That's an example of a signal. Next, we're going to demonstrate property bindings. To demonstrate property bindings, we want to set the receiver's width to the sender's width. So when the sender changes, the receiver changes automatically as well. To do this, we're going to bind to some keys. Property, we're going to make a circle. Let's call this target. And initially, this is going to be null. We want this to have focus. That way it gets keyboard input. We're going to say keys on pressed, and we're going to add a bit of JavaScript in here. Really what's going on is when we hit the minus key, the target will shrink. When we hit the positive key, the target will grow. Let's go back into the main file, and let's set the target here. That way when the keys are pressed, the sender will change size. Now, we want to bind the properties of the receiver to the sender. In this case, we're going to say width, and we want the sender.width. Let's run our example. As you can see, we have our signals and slots with graphical feedback, and we have our property bindings. So when the sender shrinks and grows, the receiver shrinks and grows. These two features are extremely powerful, and they're what set Qt and QML apart from everything else. Thank you.